whatever work people create together, I think what is most important is their involvement. How much they consider that process and that work to be their own. I think collaboration is not just limited to the presentation that we put out together, but it's really about the process of working together.
Collaboration for me is an exchange of ideas, an exchange of energies. It's not just about the art form and what we're creating. It's about personalities and characters meeting also.
There are two people who are collaborating of different genres or different art forms. It's not about retaining your unique flavor and just putting them together so there are two flavors together. No, I think that it's about merging those two flavors to create a third fresh new flavor. That is the beauty of a collaboration.
True. We've worked together, like I sing for her when she's dancing. So, you know, you develop this chemistry of being on stage and apart from watching each other perform, you're performing together, so that all always adds up to the next work that you're doing.
Oh,
collaborating with Arushi is obviously a lot of fun. It's then just not work anymore. It's about the activity. It's about, you know, the next day we have to start the shoot again, and then the conversations in between and everything. So it's all that. Also, Arushi is she's a very disciplined person by nature. So her discipline, focus, and hard work, it really adds on, like really, really adds on to the process that we're working on, to the project that we're working on.
I think Savni and I both have very different personalities. We are very different individuals, and the beauty lies in our different personalities coming together when we work together. I'm someone who gets stressed very easily, and you know that sort of comes into the work area also. And Savni is someone who stays very calm and sort of, you know, relaxed. And so she's, I think we balance each other out very well.
Also, what's helped us a lot in the collaborations that we've done with each other is actually watching our father, Srimad Mudgal, and our aunt, Srimati Madhavi Mudgal, collaborate with each other, work together. So we've seen that as kids. Most of her pieces have been composed by our father. And the way they work on the compositions, the way Madhavi Bua asks him to, you know, that this is her movement, or this is her idea, and this is how she wants it to, you know, get developed or something. And then my father has his opinions on the rag, and of course then there's this exchange of all different ideas. There are agreements and a lot of disagreements. So yeah, we've seen that all. It's fun, and we've actually really learned a lot from that.
And I think here what really is crucial is the fact that both Savni and I have trained in music and dance. So that really helps. Savni's training in dance, she's learned Bharatanatyam and the Leelaka, and she's performed also. So that sense of dance, of choreography, of visuals really helps. It helps me, in fact, when I'm choreographing something. She's the first person I go to with any idea or any movement that I create.
When I'm preparing for a concert, like Arushi has to hear the final 2-3 rehearsals and everything. Also, after that, I have to get Arushi's opinion on how it went. Then I know that this is how it truly happened, the concert. Major difference between singing a solo concert, a solo classical concert, and singing for dance, I would say, is improvisation. Yeah. you're singing your own solo piece. So it's more inward. You have this own little world of yours, and you know you're thinking about the swaras that you're about to sing and everything. So it's more about you and the tabla player. Just like a very small world, and then that sort of gets communicated outside. Whereas for dance, I think it's you have to be really alert. You have to be very focused. Just everything's on the edge. It's like watching a thriller film. Because you know, then you know that you like one mistake here or there, or an extra line or a line subtracted would then just hassle the dancer.
Yeah, because a lot of it is structured, right? In dance, I mean, there can be improvisation within that structure, but still there is a lot of structure. So I've seen this with a lot of Hindustani musicians, vocalists. They find it very hard to sing for dance with dance. It's very difficult for them to keep track of how many lines or even the movement. Even if we say, okay, just watch this is my final movement, until then you have to do a free alap. So for them, it's really, they'll get so lost in their alap that movement must have gone 20 times, but they'll miss that. So I think that's where Savni is training in dance, and also the way she responds to dance and movement is really helpful. She is not just a singer for me in my performance. She is really the person who's holding the entire team of musicians and me together, you know. She is the point of contact for me.
Also, when we're watching a dance concert, it seems very easy that, you know, everything's like in order and everything. But actually, it's, you know, like sometimes we make mistakes, the musicians. And I think the audience doesn't even know, and the dancer is the one who has to adjust, even in an abhinay piece or something. So you're like into the mood and you sort of maintain that mood and continue with the music and move along with us. That those adjustments and everything that as a dancer one has to do is, yeah, that's where the sense of music really works.
You know, sometimes on stage there are moments where the dancer feels that the lay is, the tempo is becoming a little too slow or too fast. So, you know, there's a sort of an energy exchange, and, you know, that chemistry that she was talking about, that really helps.
A little communication is always very, it's very beautiful.
Yeah. For this project, we thought we wanted to find a text that Savni could set to music and I could set to dance. And the idea really was to find something that could show two different entities coming together, for us, music and dance coming together, but really not remaining two separate entities but becoming one. And so we were going through various passages, various verses, and we came across this really beautiful verse that says, Shyam, Shyam, Shyam Ratat, Pyari Aapa Hi Shyam Bhai. Radha, she's, her love for Krishna is such, she's remembered him so much, the extent of her love is such that she herself becomes Krishna. She starts believing that she herself is Shyam. So much so that she goes around asking her friends, her sakhis, that, have you seen Radha? Have you seen her? Where is she? And she herself is asking that. Sakhi sang ki chabi nirakhat rahe sakal maun sadhe. All the sakhis, they're awestruck when they see this sight, and they just all look at her speechless.
I think it's such a nice blend of sagun and nirgun. For me, because the essence of the whole text is very nirgun, actually, when you come to think of it. And it's otherwise, it's all very, it's sagun, you know, it's easy to understand, it's a simple text. But when you actually get to the meaning, it's very deep.
For me, music is the soul for my dance. And so this coming together of music and dance and really becoming one, somewhere I think Radha becoming one with Krishna sort of symbolized that. Which is why we thought this would be a nice text to use for this project. We've taken another verse that we've used before this piece. Shyama Tori Bansuri Nek Bajaun.
Shyama Tori Bansuri. Shyama Tori Bansuri.
That's a beautiful pad by Surdas, where there is sort of an exchange happening between Radha and Krishna. Radha is telling Krishna, you should wear all my jewels and let me wear yours. Let me put my bindi on you, let me wear your mukut. You should be manini and you should, you should get upset and let me come and try and pacify you. And you can be called Radhika and let me be called Nandalal.
Such strong Shringar Ras here that I thought the best rags to be used for this has to be Kalyan and Maru Bihag. So I mixed those two and used it for this particular text. The other composition, which is Sham 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 Ratat Pyari Aap Sham Bhai. So I've consciously sort of thought about it and made it in rag Kirvani. Because again, as I mentioned before, it's a very nice blend of sagun and nirgun. So it has this shringar, yet a mystery to it, like the notes of this rag. That's what I thought would work the best for this particular composition.
It's a very beautiful verse, and I'm really happy that we've sort of just... this is just the beginning of this process of working on this piece. And so we're sharing that journey with you here.
Oh,
these days, in this strange time where everything now in the arts scenario is virtual, for me, I think I'm very lucky because Savni and I are able to take our collaboration to another level, because Savni is also into photography, so she has been shooting a lot of my work recently. We've tried to put all this together for Milap Fest, for their concept of collaboration.
We're really thankful to Milap Fest for giving us this project, because we've created something new, and during this lockdown, we've read a lot during this time with all the texts. We've gone over many ragas and everything. So it's been a beautiful journey. So thank you, Milap Fest, for that.
Thank you.